بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you guys. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you guys of those that enter Jannat al-Firdaws al-A'la. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a hadith that is sahih, that is authentic, if you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Jannah, fas'al al-Firdaws. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Firdaws. And so I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter us into Jannat al-Firdaws al-A'la bi-idhnillahi insha'Allah, and make us of those that enter Jannah bi-ghayri hisabin, without any hisab, without any account. With that being said, ya ikhwa wa ya akhawat, inshallah today we'll start a book written by al-Shaykh al-Allama, Shaykh al-Islam al-Thani, Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya rahimahullah ta'ala. And the other Shaykh, Shaykh Abdul Razzaq al-Badr, hafidhahullah ta'ala, has a ta'liq on this. This is not a complete book, rather, this is يعني, a chapter from Ibn Qayyim's kitab, Iddatu Sabirin, Dakhilatu Shakirin. And in this kitab, ya ikhwa wa ya akhawat, he explains sabr and what shukr is. Haqiqatu sabri wa haqiqatu shukri. How to have patience and how one can be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a very good book. I advise everyone to buy it and read it, and read it more than يعني, two or three times. And in this chapter, ya ikhwa, or in this kitab, he mentions 20 ways a person can stay away from sin. And this is really important. لماذا؟ لأنه يا إخوة ويا أخوات, we have a عدو. We have an enemy. And this enemy, يعني his goal is to enter you into Jahannam the same way he is going into Jahannam. He wants you to go to Jahannam with him. And so what does he do? He starts off by يعني, putting يعني, shirkiyat in front of you and kufriyat in front of you. If you don't take the bait, he makes you or he يعني, his tricks and all these things, he wants you to commit major sin or minor sin. And so what does he tell his junud, his army? He says to him or he says to them, يعني look at the soul. Whatever the soul wants, give it. لماذا؟ لأنه once the soul is in your يعني your prison, the heart will follow. And once the heart follows, and the heart now is يعني doing everything that it wants, fulfilling its desires, the jawarih will follow. And the more sin that you commit, the easier it will be for you to commit more sins. They have this one saying in Arabic, Al-Ka'sir Ula, the first drink. After the first drink, it is easy for you to drink again. After the first cigarette, it is easy for you to smoke again. After the first crime you commit, it is easy for you to commit another crime. And so what does Shaitan want from you? He wants you to commit a sin, and then all the other sins will be easy. ولكن علماؤنا, our scholars, they talked about how a person can stay away from sin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being Rabbul Alameen, the most merciful, every time you commit a sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you make tawbah, He will forgive you. And so in this kitab, ya ikhwa, inshallah, and we'll get straight into it, talks about the 20 ways. 20 ways a Muslim can stay away from sin. The Shaykh Abdul Razzaq al-Badr, rahimahullah ta'ala, wa radiyallahu anhu wa hafidhahullah, he says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I start in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. Muqaddima. He says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameena. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'ina amma ba'd. He says, فَلَمَّا كَانَتِ الذُّنُوبُ وَالْمَعَاصِي مَصْدَرَ شُؤُومٍ وَخِزْيٍ لِلْعَبْدِ كَانَ الْوَاجِبُ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ نَاصِحٍ لِنَفْسِهِ أن يسعى بعد الاستعانة بالله تعالى في البحث عن الأمور والأسباب التي تدفعه إلى مجانبتها والبعد عنها. He says, when, يعني فلما كانت الذنوب والمعاصي مصدر شؤوم وخزي للعبد. When the يعني الذنوب and the معاصي they became or when they are مصدر شؤوم, the source of every شر. Every shar that happens, every evil that happens is because of you. The sins that you commit. They say the further you are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the further you commit sins, or the more you commit sins, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you in this world. And what is the greatest punishment, ya ikhwa? Or what is greater than having a hard heart? The more you commit sins, the harder your heart is, the more your heart hardens, the further you are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you feel this wahsha, this dhulma in your heart. When it is the masdara shu'umin wa khizyin lil'abdi, he says, كَانَ الْوَاجِبُ عَلَى كُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ. It is wajib upon every Muslim, نَاصِحٍ لِنَفْسِهِ, that wants good for himself, أَنْ يَسْعَى, that he strives, بَعْدَ الْإِسْتِعَانَةِ بِاللَّهِ تَعَالَى, after seeking assistance, aid from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, في البحث عن الأمور والأسباب التي تدفعه إلى مجانبتها. It is wajib upon this abd, this Muslim, to look for things that will help him stay away from the shar. فلذلك من يعين كتاب الطهارة, Imam Ghazali رحمه الله تعالى, he says it is wajib. When you talk about tahara, he says tahara purification ينقسم إلى قسمين. It is divided into two. You have tahara that is للأعضاء, يعني for your limbs, the wudu that you make, the najasa that you wash from yourself, the istinja that you make, the ghusl that you make, وما إلى ذلك. That is the tahara للأعضاء والأبدان. He says what is wajib and a Muslim should always strive to achieve is the طهارة القلب, يعني to purify his heart from all the sicknesses, من الأمراض, يعني from مرض الشهرة, seeking يعني fame, الرياء, showing off to the people, النفاق, all these أمراض القلوب, it is wajib on the person, on a mu'min, on a Muslim, to purify his heart from. And so when we understand يا إخوة ويا أخوات, that مصدر شؤوم وخزي, the source of all evil is sins and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is wajib on the Muslim, on the mu'min, to look for things to help him so he can stay away from this evil. ولكن he says بعد الاستعانة بالله تعالى, and this is the كلام of عبد الرزاق البدر حفظه الله تعالى. He says, after the aid or seeking assistance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لماذا يا إخوة ويا أخوات? Nothing happens in this world except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you. You say 17 times a day, إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. You alone we worship and you alone we seek help. If you want to do something, you have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help. وعليكم السلام. If you want to do something, if you want to reach a certain position in life, if you want to marry someone, if you want a certain, or if you want to يعني, achieve a certain goal, this will not happen unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you. طيب, you want to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to be from the muttaqeen. You want to be from the salihin. You want to be from the abideen. You want to be from the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praises in the Quran. This is something that is lofty, something that is يعني, great. And so you have to seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بعد الاستعانة بالله في تعالى the Most High في البحث عن الأمور والأسباب التي تدفعه إلى مجانبتها والبعد عنها. فإن هذا باب, he says this is باب مهم جدا. This is a bab, a chapter, a subject that is very, very, very important. يحتاج المسلم إلى استحضارها دائما. The Muslim is always in need in remembering it. يعني reminding himself, always doing استحضار. Every single day when you wake up, every single night before you go to sleep, every single time you're walking, or you're going to work, you have to remind yourself, did I just commit a sin? Am I going to commit a sin? Am I driving to a sin? Am I taking haram money? يعني you always have to remind yourself. That's why dhikr is very, very important in our religion, ya ikhwa. The dhikr between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You always have to remind yourself of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest. You say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. You have to say Alhamdulillah, all praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You repeat it so many times until you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Akbar. Until you believe all praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until you believe in la, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, you repeat it and repeat it and repeat it. وَهُوَ الْبَاعِثُ لِلْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. What is important for the Muslim to always يعني, keep in mind is الْبَوَاعِثُ لِلْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. These بَوَاعِث, these things that help you لِلْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ, to get rid of sin. يعني before you enter or before you fall into the sin, there's something that you do. طبعاً, we are Muslims. Or طبعاً, يعني we are human beings. We are going to commit sin. We are going to fall into this sin. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he tells us, كُلُّ ابْنَ آدَمْ خَطَّاءُ وَخَيْرُ خَطَّائِينَ تَوَّابٌ. That every child of Adam, every children of Adam, they make mistakes, they will fall into sin. ولكن the best of those that make mistakes are those that return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, يعني, before you fall into this sin, or before you do this or commit this crime, يعني, there are some things that you should do before it to help you not to fall into the sin. Let's say you fell into the sin. Let's say you committed the sin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives you tawbah and istighfar. He says, وَهُوَ الْبَوَاعِثُ لِلْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. This thing that is very, very important is الْبَوَاعِثُ لِلْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ. بَوَاعِث, the thing that can help you out, لِلْخَلَاصِ, of getting rid of sins. لِيُسْلِمَ, so the Muslim, he can be safe. مِنَ الْعِقَابِ, from punishment. لِأَنَّ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى has made it a way where if you do commit a sin, if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني بمشيئته, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants and he wishes to punish you, he will punish you on the day of judgment. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to forgive you, he will forgive you. لِيُسْلِمَ مِنَ الْعِقَابِ, so he can be safe from iqab, from punishment. وَلِيَفُوزَ بِجَزِيلِ الثَّوَابِ, so he can attain thawab, reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he leaves it off. لماذا يا إخوة, we always talk about intention. If there is a sin that you are going to commit or that you want to commit, and you make the intention that you leave this sin for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will reward you. And this is the jaza, and this is the thawab that the Shaykh is talking about. He says, وَلِهَذَا, and because of this, نَجِدْ, we find الْعُلَمَاءَ, the ulama, the scholars, قَدْ أَوْضَحُوا, they have explained, هَذِهِ الْبَوَاعِثِ, they explain these things that will help you in not falling into sin. الَّتِي تُعِينُ عَلَى الْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ, those things that will help you, يعني, to get rid of sin. قَدِيمًا وَحَدِيثًا, these scholars being from the scholars of old and the scholars that, يعني, the contemporary scholars today. وَكَانَ مِنْ جُمْلَتِهِمْ, and from amongst these scholars, ya ikhwa, he says, it is al-imam al-allamatu al-murabbi ibn al-qayyimi rahimahullahu ta'ala. And from those scholars is Ibn Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala, Shaykh al-Islam al-Thani. فَقَدْ كَتَبَ, the Shaykh has wrote, فَصْلًا نَفِيسًا فِي كِتَابِهِ, he wrote a sub-chapter in his kitab. He called it عُدَّةُ الصَّابِرِينَ وَذَخِيرَةُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. This is a very, very good book. Very beautiful book. And once again, ya ikhwa, wa ya akhawat, if you can get your hands on this book, I advise you to read it. He says, ذَكَرَ فِيهِ, Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions in his kitab, عِشْرِينَ بَاعِثًا لِتَقْوِيَةِ الدِّينِ وَالْإِيمَانِ. He mentioned 20 بَوَاعِث, or بَاعِثًا, things that can help you out, لِتَقْوِيَةِ الدِّينِ وَالْإِيمَانِ, to strengthen your deen and to strengthen your iman. يعني you have Muslims, يا إخوة, every Muslim is not the same. You have a man, his iman is very high, his deen is very strong. You have a man, his iman is not that great. and his deen is not that strong. And so you're always, like working that muscle, you always need to work on your muscle. You always need to work on your deen. You always need to work on your iman. And so Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, or Ibn Razzaq al-Badr rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, Ibn Qayyim, he wrote in a sub-chapter, 20 ba'ithan, 20 things that can help you out, لِتَقْوِيَةِ الدِّينِ, to strengthen your deen, وَالْإِيمَانِ, and iman. وَالْخَلَاصِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ وَالْآثَامِ, and to get rid of dhunub and al-atham, sins. جمعها جمعا متينا متينا وبينها بيانا نافعا. He says he gathered it and he explained it in a very beautiful way. فأحببت, he says, عبد الرزاق البدر, الشيخ عبد الرزاق البدر, he says, فأحببت, I liked and I loved ذكرها أو ذكرها في هذا المختصر. He says, I want and I wish, يعني and I love to mention it in this مختصر. والتعليق عليها and to comment on it. بما يوضح مقاصدها مقاصدها and to يعني clarify its مقاصد what is intended يعني ويجلي معانيها and to clarify its معاني the meaning of what Ibn Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى is trying to say حتى يعم نفعها until its نفع its benefit can encompass everyone بين المسلمين between the Muslims وتكون لها and it can become باب توبة وخلاص من الذنوب and it can be a bab, a door for him to make tawbah and to get rid of sin and to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh, he says, Wallaha Allah, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yarhama, to have mercy ala al-imam, yani an yarhama al-imam ibn al-qayyimi, to have mercy on Imam ibn al-qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, wa an yarfa'a darajatahu, and to raise his ranks in the akhirah, fi jannati al-na'imi in jannah, wa an yaghfira lana, and that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us, wa lahu, and to forgive Ibn al-qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, wa li jami'i al-muslimina, and all the Muslims in the world, those that passed away and those that are alive. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. He says وكتبه عبد الرزاق ابن عبد المحسن البدر. Now we're going to go into the book. The way the Shaykh did this book is very simple. He mentions a مشهد, one of the ways to get rid of the sin. And then Shaykh عبد الرزاق البدر, he does the تعليق on it. So he says, قال الإمام ابن القيم, إمام ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى, he says, فصل, أي هذا فاصل, وأما تقوية باعث الدين فإنه يكون بأمور, بأمور. He says, as for the تقوية, يعني strengthening, باعث الدين, the thing that can help you with the deen, فإنه يكون بأمور, it happens in many ways. He says, أحدها, from the ways that يعني you can strengthen this ba'ith is إجلال الله تبارك وتعالى أن يعصى وهو يرى ويسمع ومن قام بقلبه مشهد إجلاله لم يطاوعه قلبه لذلك البتة. Now the first way, Ibn Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى, he wants you, or he's helping us in escaping sin. Not to commit sins, not to fall into sin. And so he says the first mashhad is ijlalullah, the reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani to respect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to magnify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you remember this, he's trying to say, before you commit a sin, always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created you, the one that provides for you, the one that sustains you, the one that looks at you, the one that sees you, the one that knows you more than you know yourself, the one that is more merciful to you than anyone in this world, the one that is more merciful to you than your own self. لماذا؟ لأنه sometimes, يا إخوة, the sins that we commit are sins that يعني we think we're protecting ourselves. One might commit a sin just to attain more money. لماذا؟ لأنه he fears that he won't have enough money this month. So he might take riba, or he might do something haram just to get this money. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala is saying, before you fall into this sin, before you do this, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that sees you, The one that hears you. The one that created you. Right? He says, إِجْلَالُ اللَّهِ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. To revere Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَنْ يُعْصَى. That he is disobeyed. وَهُوَ يَرَى. While he sees. وَيَسْمَعْ. And he hears. And always keep in mind that when you are falling into this sin, or when you are doing this sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. Yani, sometimes what does the shaitan do to us? The shaitan, he makes us do things and we forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلِذَلِكَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he calls him الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. He calls him الخناس, the one that withdraws. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, when he was explaining this ayah, he says, Shaytan, he whispers. He whispers and he comes to you when you are forgetful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he withdraws when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so when you're falling into the sin, the first condition or the first strategy that Shaytan uses is he makes you forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani, look at your day. Do you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Some of the sins that we commit, do we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us? Do we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears our munajah? When we are yani, planning to betray someone, or planning to harm someone, or planning to do something to someone, do we remember in that majlis that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears us? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees us? And if we did, what would we do? I believe every Muslim sitting here and every Muslim that hears this, if they hear Allah is watching you, Allah sees you, they will stop. لماذا؟ لأنه a mu'min is a mu'min that respects Allah and that reveres Allah and that glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so shaitan, what does he do? He makes you forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so next time you commit a sin, ya ikhwa, or next time you want to commit a sin, or next time your heart or your desire or your souls is calling you to sin, the first thing that you should remember is Jalalullah. You have to revere Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears you. And this will help you in not falling into the sin. He says, وَمَنْ قَامَ بِقَلْبِهِ مَشْهَدُ إِجْلَالِهِ لَمْ يُطَاوِحُ قَلْبُهُ لِذَٰلِكَ الْبَتَّةَ. He says, whoever has in his قلب مشهد إجلاله, the reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his heart, whoever reveres Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, magnifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? لَمْ يُطَاوِحُ قَلْبُهُ. His قلب, his heart, will never, يعني it will never obey the desire. لِذَٰلِكَ الْبَتَّةَ, to the sin. أَبَدًا. If your heart, if you fill your heart with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you continue to purify your heart, it will be hard for your soul to call you to sin. It will be hard for the shaitan to trick you. That is the ba'ith al-awwal, or al-ba'ith al-awwal, na'am. The shaykh, he says, al-ba'ith al-awwali, أو الباعث الأول للخلاص من الذنوب. This the كلام of عبد الرزاق البدر حفظه الله. He says الباعث الأول, the first thing that can help you in staying away from sin, in escaping these sins, للخلاص من الذنوب, is إجلال الله سبحانه وتعالى وإعظامه. Venerating Allah سبحانه وتعالى and revering Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وذلك, he says, and that is أن يشهد المرء, that this مرء that he has in his heart, في قلبه يعني جلال الله, he has in his heart the reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How great is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that created you, the one that provides for you, the one that has mercy on you, the one that sees you, the one that gave you every ihsan, every ni'mah that you have, the clothes that you have on your back, The rizq that you have or that you get every month, the car that you drive, the family that you are from, the eyesight that you have, the intellect that you have, everything that you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. هُوَ الْأَوَّلُ وَالْآخِرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was before everything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be after everything. He is Qadeer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was there before we were even created. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one that gave us the Ruh. He is the one that gave us this Quran. He is the one that sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yani once you have this type of jalal, ijlal in your heart, this reverence in your heart, once you learn who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from the Quran, and then it will be very hard for your heart to accept this shahwat. Kama qala ta'ala, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّةٌ بِيَمِينِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They have not revered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the right reverence. يعني they have not put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the position that He deserves. يعني by committing shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did they do? They did not revere Him, venerate Him the way he deserves. تمام؟ والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة الآية. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا وقد خلقكم أطوارا ما لكم what is the matter with you. لا ترجون أي لا تخافون. You're not scared لله وقارا. You're not scared of a punishment. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the way He told the people of Nuh, ما لكم, what's wrong with you. لا ترجون لله وقارا. You're not scared of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not fear His punishment. وَقَدْ خَلَقَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has indeed created you. أَطْوَارًا. قَالَ ابْنِ عَبَّاسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. أَطْوَارًا يعني in stages. قَالَ ابْنِ عَبَّاسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. He says, فِي تَفْسِيرِهَا أَيْ مَا لَكُمْ لَا تُعَظِّمُونَ اللَّهَ حَقَّ عَظَمَتِهِ. أي what is wrong with you? Why are you not venerating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He deserves to be venerated? Why are you not يعني showing this azama to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing whatever you want to do, by living life the way you want to live, by waking up in the morning, not thinking and not knowing that you are a abd, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants something from you. يعني ما لكم? What is wrong with you? وقال القرطبي, إمام القرطبي رحمه الله تعالى, he says في تفسير قوله, in the tafsir of this ayah, أطوارا, the كلمة أطوارا, he says, أي طورا بعد طور إلى تمام الخلق. Stages after stages until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completes you in creation or in creating you. فمن فعل هذا, this is the كلام of القرطبي رحمه الله تعالى, he says, فمن فعل هذا وقدر عليه. Whoever has done this and is capable of doing this, يعني creating you from a nutfa to a mudgha to idan to lahm to the person that you are today, to making it easy for you to come out the womb, for Allah for making it easy for you to be fed, for you accepting this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doing all of this for you from when you are a nutfa until you are a grown man, until you pass away, the God that did this, فَمَنْ فَعَلَ هَذَا وَقَدِرَ عَلَيْهِ, and is capable of this, فَهُوَ أَحَقُّ أَن تُعَظِّمُهُ. He has right that you venerate Him. يعني the God that created you from يعني stage one to stage two to this stage, وَمَا إِلَى ذَلَكَ, the one that had you and watched you all this time, He has the right to be venerated. ومن شواهد تأثير هذا المشهد في النفوس ما جرى للصحابي الجليل جبير بن مطعم رضي الله عنه. And what would testify to this effect? يعني having this reverence in your heart and this reverence helping you to iman and to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ما جرى للصحابي الجليل, what happened to the صحابي جبير بن مطعم لما قرع سمعه بعض الآيات. When Jubayr ibn Mut'im, before he was a Muslim, he heard the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala التي فيها بيان عظمة الله. That in these ayat that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you will see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the one that was reciting it, In these ayat, يعني they have the عظمة, the عظمة of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وقام في قلبه مقام إجلال الله وجبروته وجبروته. And in his heart, the reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ta'zeem of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was there. وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ الْخَالِقُ. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the Khaliq. وَالرَّازِقُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the provider. وَالْمُتَصَرِّفُ بِجَمِيعِ الْخَلْقِ. And He is the one that is al-mutasarrif. He can do whatever He wants with His creation. He gives to who He wants. He takes from who He wants. He gives children to who He wants, and He doesn't give children to who He wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَعَالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدُ. He does whatever He wishes. دَفَعَهُ ذَلِكَ. Once Jubayr ibn Mut'im, رضي الله عنه, he heard these things. He heard this, دَفَعَهُ ذَلِكَ. يعني the ayat pushed him. لِلْإِيمَانِ to iman, to believe. ودخول الإسلام and to enter Islam. حيث قال وإن said. And so what the Shaykh is trying to say, يا إخوة يا أخوات, is this. يعني Ibn Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى, he mentions that one of the ways or one of the things that can help you in staying away from sin, in escaping sin, or you have this sin that you can't يعني overcome, that you are persistent in, one of the things that can help you is by remembering Allah, revering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sitting down and doing dhikr, yani pondering over the ayat, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. فَلِذَلِكَ يعني يا إخوة, the Sahaba, they had this thing where they would come to each other and they say, يعني هيا بنا نؤمن ساعة, يعني let's come together and let's believe for an hour. يعني let's do dhikr. Let's remind each other of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, when you sit down and you come to majalis like this, once a week, twice a week, three times a week, and you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once you do this, this has an effect on you. And so the next time you are committing this sin or you're struggling with this sin, always remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. And so the dalil for this, ya ikhwah, wa ya akhwat, يعني Abd al-Razzaq al-Badr, he says, that is the story of the Sahabi al-Jaleel, Jubayr ibn Mut'im. Jubayr ibn Mut'im, radiallahu anhu, one day he was in Mecca. And he heard the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being recited by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so these ayat, يعني in it are يعني it proves that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa al-khaliq. Allah, He is the creator. And once you understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, you will come to the conclusion that He has the right to command and forbid you. لماذا؟ لأن أنت يعني عبد, you are His slave. He created you for a purpose. And you have to fulfill that purpose. And if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is punishment. Once you understand this, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala and Abd al-Razzaq al-Badr and the ulama, they are saying this will push you to iman. This will help you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, دَفَعَهُ ذَلِكَ لِلْإِيمَانِ وَدُخُولِ الْإِسْلَامِ حَيْثُ قَالَ. Where Jubayr ibn Mut'im, he says, سَمِعْتُ النَّبِيَّ, I heard the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقرأ في المغرب, reading مغرب بالطور. Jubayr ibn Mut'im رضي الله عنه, he was in Mecca at this time, يقرأ بالطور, he was reading Surah Al-Tur. فلما بلغ هذه الآيات, and when he reached these آيات, أم خلقوا من غير شيء أم هم الخالقون أم خلقوا السماوات والأرض بل لا يوقنون أم عندهم خزائن ربك أم هم المسيطرون. He says, كاد قلبي أن يطير. He says, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم reciting سورة الطور, huh, في المغرب. And he's listening. Jubayr ibn Mut'im رضي الله عنه, he is listening. And he says, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he reached, هذه الآيات, these آيات, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ, were they created from nothing? أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ, or are they the creators? يعني, you have to understand, this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's talking to the Quraysh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's talking to the kuffar, those that don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, هيا, you see this? Everything that you see, this cone that you see, this earth that you see, these stars, يعني أنت أنفسك, يعني نفسك, that you see your eyes and everything, is either one of three things. You were either created from nothing. يعني nothing happened, and out of nowhere, poof, something happened. Or you yourselves are, يعني you created yourself. أنت, you created yourself. That's impossible. So what is the last thing that, يعني that's possible? There is a creator. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ, were they created from nothing? أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ, or were they the ones that created? أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ, or have they created the السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ? طبعاً we haven't. We don't know any human being that can create anything. يعني this world that you see, the السَّمَاوَاتِ, the sun, the, يعني everything that you see, no one can do it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ, يعني they have no yaqeen. أَمْ عِنْدَهُمْ, or with them, is خَزَائِنُ رَبِّكَ, يعني the خزائن, the treasure, يعني everything that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do they possess it? أَمْ هُمُ الْمُسَيْطِرُونَ, or are they the, يعني the dictators over it? يعني why are they acting like this? Why are they living life in a way where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not hold them accountable? Why are they waking up? Or why are you waking up in the morning and fulfilling your desires? This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to tell you. لماذا? لأنه there is a Lord. There is a creator. And he created you for something. And so you as a Muslim, you as a human being, you have to search for your purpose of life. The reason why you were created. And it is khalq. It is ibadah. قال جبير, جبير رضي الله عنه, he says, كاد قلبي أن يطير, يعني my heart almost flew, يعني because of the عظمة of these آيات. He understood these آيات. وفي لفظ آخر, in another narration, وذلك أول ما وقر الإيمان في قلبي, and that is the first time إيمان has entered my heart. After I heard these آيات, this is the first time I heard these آيات. So عبد الرزاق البدر رحمه الله تعالى, he says, فالعبد, the slave, إذا حدثته نفسه بارتكاب ذنب من الذنوب, if his soul talks to him or calls him to commit a sin from the many sins, فليشهد بقلبه جلال الله وعظمته وجبروته. Once you start to feel these desires coming up, ya ikhwa, wa ya akhawat, once you see your nafs calling you to sin, calling you to do something, the first thing that you should do is remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember his ihsan, remember his ni'am, remember his favors upon you. لماذا? لأنه Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنه, he says that when you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when this jalal enters your heart, then what happens? Shaitan, he withdraws. And so this is the first step that one should do staying away and escaping sin. He says, فَالْعَبْدُ إِذَا حَدَّثَتْهُ نَفْسُهُ بِارْتِكَابِ ذَنْبٍ مِّنَ الذُّنُوبِ فَلْيَشْهَدْ بِقَلْبِهِ جَلَالَ اللَّهِ وَعَظَمَتَهُ وَجَبُرُوتَهُ وَأَنَّهُ مُطَلِّعٌ عَلَىٰ أَفْعَالِهِ وَأَقْوَالِهِ. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one that is aware, that sees على أفعاله, his أفعال, his actions, وأقواله, and his sayings. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees what you do, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what you say. فإذا استشعر العبد ذلك بقلبه, when the abd, he feels this in his heart, كف عن ارتكاب الذنوب بإذن الله لا محال. يعني he stays away from committing this sin, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, طبعا, لا محالة, أي لا بد. And so, remember, the first step to escape from sin, or to help you staying away from sin, is to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once you do this, this will help you in staying away from sin. قال بشر بن الحارث الحافي بشر بن الحارث, he says, لو تفكر الناس, if the people pondered and thought, في عظمة الله, in the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, if the people pondered over the ayah, يعني the asma, in the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if people only knew the true faqr, how in need they are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghani, if people only pondered over this, لَمَا عَصَوْهُ, they would not, يعني, disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this comes from what, ya ikhwa? It comes from, or sin comes from, يعني, not remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so one of the ways that we can escape this is by remembering Allah. The second mashhad. قال ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى الثاني مشهد محبته سبحانه فيترك معصيته محبة له فإن المحب لمن يحب مطيعه وأفضل الترك ترك المحبين كما أن أفضل الطاعة طاعة المحبين فبين ترك المحب وطاعته وترك من يخاف العذاب وطاعته بون بعيد. He says المشهد الثاني, or the second way, the second thing that can help you in staying away from sin. The first was revering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, venerating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembering his, يعني his might. The second thing is محبته سبحانه, the love that you have for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the love, your love as a human being, as a Muslim, يعني the love that you have for Allah. فيترك معصيته محبة له, يعني he leaves disobeying him out of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لماذا? He says, فَإِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ, because the one that loves, he is مُطِيع لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ, he is obedient to the one that he loves. If you love someone, they say true love is seeing the person that you love happy, making sure that they're good. The best example I can give you guys is your kids, your children. Wallahi, a father or a mother will do everything they can to make that child happy. Everything. Everyone around you is saying you're doing too much. You're doing this. They don't understand it. You will stay up all night to make sure your child is good. You will work 12 hours, 16 hours to make your child happy. You will spend money that you don't have to buy something for your child. لماذا? لأنه this is true حب. This is true love. And you will sacrifice a lot of things for your child. How many parents sacrifice friendships? Their time to be with their children. Right? And so this is what true love is. And so when you truly love something, or when you truly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all you want to do is obey Him. And never anger Him. When you truly love someone, you never want to see them mad. And you never want to anger them. All you want to do is make them happy. فَإِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ, because the one that loves, مُطِيعُ, he is obedient to the one that he loves. And so Ibn Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى, he says, وَأَفْضَلُ التَّرْكِ, and the best ترك, يعني leaving sin or leaving something, تَرْكُ الْمُحِبِّينَ, is the ترك, the one that loves, when he leaves something for the one that he loves. That is the best, يعني ترك. When you give up something as a human being, there's many ways you can give something up. You can give something up for yourself. You can give something up for somebody else. ولكن when you give something up, when you stop doing something out of love for somebody else, this is the best. And so Ibn Qayyim رحمه الله تعالى, he says, فَأَفْضَلُ أو أَفْضَلُ التَّرْكِ تَرْكُ الْمُحِبِّينَ كَمَا أَنَّ أَفْضَلَ الطَّاعَةِ طَاعَةُ الْمُحِبِّينَ. The same way, يعني the best obedience is the obedience of the one that you love. يعني when you love someone and when you obey him, not because you're scared of him, not because you want something from him, or not because there's his interest in it for you, Rather, you obey someone or you do something for someone out of love. Right? You can stay in the hospital for months. Months for your mother. يعني you will lose your job. You will do a lot. يعني you will do it for your mother. لماذا? Out of love. The love that you have for your mom. Right? And that is the best ta'ah. And when she tells you to go do something, you go do it. So he says, فَبَيْنَ تَرْكِ الْمُحِبِّ وَطَاعَتِهِ وَتَرْكِ مَنْ يَخَافُ الْعَذَابَ وَطَاعَتِهِ مَوْنٌ بَعِيدٌ He says between, يعني the difference between the one that leaves something out of love and does something out of love is very far away from the one that leaves something out of fear. Fear of al-adab. You fearing, يعني not to do this sin, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you, is different from you leaving this sin out of love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's two different things. You left, let's say, taking riba. لماذا? لأنه you know whoever takes riba has, يعني, said they are at war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you. This person, he fears the iqab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولكن he is different to the person that leaves riba. لماذا? لأنه Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said leave it. And he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a difference between these two people. And so a Muslim, ya ikhwa, wa ya akhwat, should always strive to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to strengthen this love and to do the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Right? Allahumma inni as'aluka hubbak wa hubba man yuhibbuk wa amal alladhi yuqarribu ila hubbik. Yani you always say, oh Allah, I ask you for your love and the love of those that you love. And the actions that get me closer to your love. This is a dua that you should always be making. So he says, عبد الرزاق البدر رحمه الله تعالى ورضي الله عنه وحفظه الله. He says, التعليق الثاني من هذه البواحث. The second thing, محبة الله. يعني the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما قال تعالى, like the Most High said, والذين آمنوا, those that believe, أشد حبا لله. They have more love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, فَإِذَا أَشْغَلَ الْعَبْدُ قَلْبَهُ بِحُبِّ اللَّهِ If the slave, أَشْغَلَ قَلْبَهُ He busies his heart بِحُبِّ اللَّهِ with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you're always busy in doing things to earn the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to take steps towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your goal and your only ghaya is the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the rida, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, صَرَفَهُ هَذَا الْإِنْشِغَالِ عَنِ الْوُقُوعِ فِي مَا يُغْضِبُهُ يعني this انشغال, this business will يعني take him away. عَنِ الْوُقُوعِ in committing or falling into فِي مَا يُغْضِبُهُ And what angers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? لِأَنَّ الْمَعَاصِي وَالذُّنُوبِ تُفَوِّتُ عَلَى الْعَبْدِ حَظَّهُ وَنَصِيبُهُ مِنْ مَحَبَّةِ اللَّهِ Because ma'asi and dhunub, they make him miss the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني you take steps. Every time you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every time you want to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you commit a sin, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he tell us? He told us that there is a black dot that will be on your heart. And so every time you commit sin, and the more sins that you commit, the further away you will be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَهُ بِحَسْبِ مَا وَقَعَ فِيهِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ وَالْخَطَايَا And every sin is not the same, ya ikhwa. The man that lied and the man that murdered are not the same. They're not the same sin. طبعاً, yes, the ulama that will argue, يعني at the end of the day, a sin is a sin. ولكن, The gravity of a man that murdered an innocent person and a person that lied, لا يستويا, they're not the same. تمام? And so the more you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if you commit a sin, بحسب ذنبك وخطيئتك, it takes you away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولأن المحبة الصادقة لله, he says, and because المحبة الصادقة, the real love, لله for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مستلزمة it necessitates true love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala necessitates and brings about لامتثال أوامره. يعني fulfilling the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you truly say I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means you will fulfill and do everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you to do. واجتنابي ما يسقطه. And to stay away from what angers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كما قال تعالى, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله. Say, إن كنتم تحبون الله. If you really love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فاتبعوني, follow me. يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Follow me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you. يعني you claim that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You claim that you can't go to sleep because of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You claim what you're doing is because of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. ولكن the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a condition, يا إخوة. And it is to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you really love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is telling you, you will get my love if you follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And your love is sadiq. You have true love. And what you're saying is true if you follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاتَّبِعُونِي, follow my sunnah. يحببكم الله تعالى يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. ولذلك قيل, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love us inshallah. ولذلك قيل, and therefore it was said, and this is the bait of Imam Shafi'i رحمه الله تعالى. He says, تعصي الإله وأنت تظهر حبه, هذا محال في القياس بديع. لو كان حبك صادقا لأطعته, إن المحب لمن يحب مطيع. He says, تعصي الإله. You disobey Allah. وأنت تظهر حبه. And you make your hub, your love that you have for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala apparent. يعني, how? Inside, when no one is watching you, when no one sees you, تعصي الإله. You disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولكن, تظهر حبه. You make the حب that you have apparent. You show the people. I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cry in front of the people. وما إلى ذلك. He says, هذا محال. This is impossible. في القياس بديع. لماذا؟ لو كان حبك, if your حب صادقا, was truly, يعني was honest, لأطعته. You would have obeyed him. إن المحب, the one that loves, مُطِيعُ, he is obedient, لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ, to the one that he loves. يعني love, true love, brings about obedience. And so, if you want to stay away from sin, if you want to escape sin, work on the love that you have. Work on the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By implementing the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. هذا وبالله توفيق وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We'll stop here inshallah this week.